in the way that I walk. I keep a G in the way that I talk. They came to me when they needed the rail. I came to me when I needed support. Same ones was happy, it looked like the end. They came to me when they needed a start. I never needed a reason to be anything other than what I've been from the start. Whoa, you are now tuned in. You about to walk with Frozy. If I said it, then I meant it. You already know, you know me. Ay, ay. Started from the bottom, always been a problem. Who gon' control me? Ay, ay. It's nothing but real ones around me. It's Mr. Montgomery County.
Frozy. Welcome back to the channel, man. Happy to see y'all. Hopefully y'all happy to see me. Happy hump day. It is Wednesday. Third blog of the week. We've done one every day so far. I promised y'all last week I was doing five all week this week. And I'm holding true to my promise. Now y'all hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and comment below. Let me know what y'all think. Anybody who's been here since we started, they know I interact with everybody, right? First two blogs we did this week, we were covering some cars that were coming up. Blackout 8, Civil War. Got some more cars to talk about on the back end of the week. But, you know, for now, that's what we've been talking about. For today, though, I don't have a card to talk about. I don't have a battle to talk about, right? I said something in my blog yesterday. I said, hey, Rum, after this battle, can we take some PTO? Can we take some time off, right? Just a couple, 3-4 weeks, which is about 2 months in battle, right? Can we just take some time off, right? And I thought, it was on my thought process all day, and I thought, damn, maybe I should have put a little bit more context on that for anybody who didn't understand what I was referring to. So, first, let's start here. Everybody knows that Rum Nitty and Beloved has been going back and forth. Every fucking day almost. And yes, I do want to see that battle. Now, Hitman Holla and Lux started talking like they were going to battle. I think that's cooled off a little bit. And here we back are. We're right back with the Nitty and Lux. That's heating up again. Right? I see Nitty. Sit your scary ass down if you ain't going to come outside, right? Lux, your scary ass. Mook, you keep dropping your 2 cents. I'm going to get with your goofy ass when I'm done, Lux. Right? So it's revving up a little bit, but I think what's being missed in all this is the reason why it seems so difficult to happen. Or maybe why Lux seems to have a little bit of, yeah, I'll do it. Nah, I don't want to do it. Yeah, a little bit of doubt. 1 minute it looks like he wants to do it, and then you'll have a fucking blogger come out and say, well, I spoke to Lux. He don't want to battle Rum Nitty, right? So, yeah, I don't know what the fuck to believe, but I understand both sides of it. I'm going to try to break this down for y'all, right? This is a prize fight. You know why it's a prize fight? Because Lux is involved. There's about 4 to 7 battlers max that can freeze time when they come outside. Meaning all the rules go out the window. What we use to critique or dock or give points to the battlers on a daily basis, well, we change it when these guys come outside. Well, Lux is one of these guys we're talking about. Lux is the A-side versus Rum Nitty. Do you guys understand that? And if they put a poll up right now, I didn't say Lux would be the favorite to win the battle. Rum Nitty would be the favorite going into the battle. Lux is still the A-side. Make no mistakes about it. Now, when you're the A-side, it means you have some clout. You know, it means you can control a little bit of how the negotiations go, which you should. A-sides have... to a certain degree, they've earned that. You know, Rum's outside a little too much at this point, right? Like, this is what I meant by PTO. Well, Rum has nothing to prove here yet but legacy battles. Think about it. The only thing Rum could do now at this point to up his brand is take legacy battles. That's it. Your Mook, your Luxes, those level of battles. Whether, you know, you think he will win those battles or not, those are the ones he needs to get to that final level. Because he's right there. He's really done everything. But these matchups only happen once a year. And when you're accessible, when you're just outside so much, it hurts those big matches because the A side can say, yo, you know, I only come out once a year, once every other year. Well, why would I battle Rum Nitty if Foots can battle him? And no disrespect to you, Foots. I know you want to come up here. We talk my shit up, you know, a little bit more on a superstar level. Not to say you are or not, you know. You're here for a reason, so I want to make sure I give you some love, too. But Foots, you in the fucking way right now. Your shot that you're about to get for Rum Nitty that I'm happy that you're getting is in the way of this Lux battle. Shit like this. Now, Rum, I let you slide on the Illmac. Because on the same type of, you know, he's a legend in his own right. So we'll let you slide there. Just, you know, when you take a level battle of Foots at this time, when you're in the talks for Beloved, you got to know that ain't the right move. Now, let's break this down on why it's not the right move. See, first of all, Rum Nitty's in a tough spot, right? Rum Nitty's in a tough spot because if you remember, they were saying he worked at Walmart. That was like an old angle. Now, I don't know if he ever worked at Walmart or not, but I did hear that he quit his job for battle rap. I think I've even heard him say that. So if battle rap is your job, well, who are we to say, you know, that check that he goes and gets, you know, that's part of his yearly income, his monthly income, you know, his quarterly, however you want to break it down. If battle rap's your income, your main source of income, well, then I can understand why he's taking these matchups. But it also, there's a downside to that. Okay, yeah, you can make your money monthly, good money to do what you love, perform for 9 minutes. But then we can't go get the mega bag, the mega opportunity because we're so accessible, right? Now, there's payment levels in battle rap, right? You got your guys that are making your 20s to 40s. There's less than a dozen guys doing that. They're probably less than 10, closer to 5 than 10 maybe, right? Those are your God tier guys. They come outside and they just sell tickets no matter what the fuck else is on the card. They can sell it. It's like 6 to 7 guys getting that type of money, right? 20 to 40. Then you got where a lot of your top tiers and your favorite battlers are. You're 10 to 19, right? Occasionally you'll jump up, get a 20, little 20 piece. But for your, you know, average, you're getting anywhere from about 10 to 19,000. It's where a lot of your top tier and favorite battlers are, right? Then you got your five, you know, your little 4, 5 grand to 9 grand guys. Those are the guys right there on the bubble, right? There's a lot of battlers, a lot of good battlers in this payment threshold, right? And then you got your 500 to 5,000 guys, right? Doing it for the love, little 1,500, you know, for hip hop. Right? A little 15, 2,500. So those are the payment thresholds, right? Let's just put Rum in the 10. Let's just say we put Rum hypothetically in the 10 to 19 grand range. That right under God tier level where a lot of the top tiers are. We put him there, right? I mean, I'm not going to not go pick up 13 grand for Foots. I get it. You gonna pay me 13 to go battle Foots? I'm gonna battle Foots. But if I can get 27 to battle Lux, well, I sit the fuck down a little bit because also once I get up there to that 27, I'm probably gonna cook Lux. I'm the alien. No disrespect, Beloved. I might not have to go back down to that 10 to 15 level no more. Cause I sat out, I waited, got the Lux battle, got my little 28 highest payday, and then I knocked it out the fucking park. I'm not going back down. I'm only going up. That's how this shit goes. So, for me, I understand Lux side of it also. And listen, you trying to battle me, Beloved. And a lot of people ain't just walking around saying they got Lux on their resume. That's a thing. That's a thing. Right? So, Lux isn't just... Foots can't battle Lux. Right? I'm not sure if fucking Lux know who Foots is. And I do. I got up on him. You know what I'm saying? Pause. That was crazy. I got up on who Foots was and who he is in battle rap. Pardon. But, you know, so, listen, this is what, when you have an A and B side, it only matters when you get up to this God tier level. And sometimes, you know, to get that big battle, you just got to dial back a little bit. You know what I mean? Sit out for some time. Make it make sense. Do your promo on it. You're Rum Nitty. So Rum has to find that balance of quality over quantity. Again, if that's his main source of income, this is his job. So he does have to accommodate that with his living expenses, whatever they may be. But, you know, you understand why Deluxe Battle seems difficult to make instead of just saying do it. From a content standpoint, it makes sense. But if you on Lux side, it's like, well, you don't get to go battle like somebody like that and then come battle me. That bring my shit down. Right? Let's say he lose the foots, but Beloved would have already agreed to do the battle in November. And then then Nitty go beat him. Well, now Beloved just lost to somebody that foots beat. Lux not doing that. Lux not doing that. You got Lux gonna strike when the iron hot, when it makes sense. Jay-Z was tweeting his shit. You know? Now I know Beloved ain't got the best winning record, but he's still one of the biggest draws outside. Shitting me? I'd go fucking swimming with crocodiles right now if Lux wanted to battle me. Let's do it. That's Lux. Honey, throw the party. It's happening. We made it. That's what Lux brings to the table. There's only a few guys that can give you that. So that's why I said take some PTO time. Rum, that's why I said that. I didn't mean no disrespect. We all know that you have the skills to pay the bills and the bars to make stars. We know you're the alien. Do you know you're the alien? You are. You're the alien. If your friends won't tell you, Frozy will. You're fucking Martian. Well, from not of this world. Is that how you say it in the cartoons? From not of this world. We all know how good you are, Rum. Sometimes I question, do you know how good you are? Right? Rum's got all the talent to be the best battler in the world and carry it. It's a branding thing. It's a branding thing. And it has a lot to do with how accessible he is and how outside he is. How you can go watching battle somebody of the level of fucking Geechee and then go watching battle somebody who just got out of the final exams. And I feel like the battle leagues be wanting that though. It's just because if I'm a battle owner and I'm a promoter and I'm this guy who's paying all these guys and I know this guy right here really got all the check marks across all the boxes to be the number one guy in the sport, but he ain't holding his own shit respectfully to that standard. I don't want him. I'm not tipping him off like, yo, you know you're the best in the world, right? You know we only paying you 11, but we should be paying you 20, could be paying you 25. They ain't gonna tell nobody that. Pardon, coming down with a little cold, but I just don't know if maybe Rum, you know, maybe Rum feels like, you know, maybe Rum feels like he's getting the right amount of money right now, but I don't, I feel like Rum Nitty should be looked at, and he is from a talent standpoint, but it's just different though. We look at dudes who aren't as good as him, as bigger brands than him. He doesn't need a rebranding, he just needs some fucking, he needs a few tweaks. And maybe, you know, a little bit more thought into who we're taking as opponents and who can have an opportunity to say they battle Rum. If Rum didn't battle for 2 years right now, we'd miss him dearly. Well, I'm not telling you to go away for a year, let alone two. I'm not even saying go away for 6 months. I'm just saying take some time off so Battle Rap knows what it feels like to not have Rum. Because we got too comfortable with this shit, Rum. Yeah, no, act like now we just acting like it's normal. The shit you do isn't normal. You're special. You're special. Let's start acting like it. Pissing me off, man. And Beloved. All right, I know. I get it. But let's take an outside battle, Beloved. Right? Let's take a. You know what? Y'all think he the more, you know, the most dangerous dude in the game right now? Fuck it. I go clip him real quick. I'm Lux. But then that will go against what makes Lux so special. That's why he's so special. Because he don't just do that. So maybe we should start taking some fucking pages and some lessons out of Lux's book and understand how he got there. You know Lux didn't have that many battles before he came out of retirement? And count them. Count the battles that you remember seeing him in before he came out of retirement to battle Calico. technically, what the fuck has he done besides be a star in the dinosaur age before the sport started? And then, you know, he created Lions, then had a battle league. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about strictly from a battle standpoint. What the fuck has he done to be? I didn't see him on Fight Club. I didn't see him running around battling the Sirius Joneses and call, you know, he just wasn't as active as like a Murder Mook or a T-Rex was. But yet he's just as prestige, if not more than all of them. Why? Why? Because he's the man, the myth, the legend. You think Lux didn't know that? He's very smart. Very smart. So shout out to you two brothers. I really want to see this fucking battle. I really do. I didn't, but now I do. Got annoyed with it real quick. I wanted to see Holla. I wanted to see Holla and Lux in that blue room. But listen, I'm going to be totally honest. As much as that's a mega fight too, I'd rather see Nitty and Lux actually at this point. I changed my mind. Man, I'd like to see Nitty in the blue room too. Nitty in the fucking blue room might be a cheat code. Might be a cheat code. And speaking of blue room, damn, Lux might be fucking unbeatable in that room too. You ain't got no crowd. Oh my God. Adam, what we doing? Adam, I'm telling you now, I know you're on vacation. I know this. Oh shit. Oh shit. Get that water. Rosenberg just took us to the blue room. Oh, mid-block. I've never seen that done before. You ever see the blue room? Just hit that bitch. Blue room. Now we in the blue room. You see how easy it was? I said, yo. I'm telling you. Lux in the blue room, fire. Rum Nitty in the blue room, fire. Hitman proved it. After battling 11th, after 10 battles went before him, still was rocking the house. Still was rocking the house in the blue room. Twerk. Blue room just volume with a blue light. Well, no, it isn't. You ever been in the blue room, twerk? You ever seen the blue room? I ain't talking about a fucking LED light you could put in your lamp at the crib. Or like I did. I ain't talking about that. It's a vibe. If you haven't been in the building, you haven't seen it, probably shouldn't speak on it just because you don't know it's different. I'd like to see twerk in the blue room. Pause. I'd like to see New Jersey twerk. Pause. Y'all know what I mean, man. It's your boy Frozy. We 3 for 3. Hopefully, we're going to talk about some Battle Academy coming up. I want to get on them final exams. Talk about that also. I might go live. We'll see. Just want to come here and give my thoughts today on this Rum Nitty and Lux situation. And, yeah, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit them motherfucking comments. And if you want to talk with Froze, like, you know, I chop it up with the fans in the comments. I do. I please don't hit that fucking subscribe button, man. You already know what it is. It's Froze. I see you when I see you.